activity, lab activity means how many different images, what is the image length, what is the image object, where we are finding the object, we find the image distance as well as object distance, all this we done in an activity. And today I already told you about in next class we are discussing about ray diagrams basing on contour mirror as well as convex mirror and magnification and the power of a lens. All these concepts we will discuss in this today's class. Okay, and first is ray diagram on a for a convex contour mirror. Contour mirror, if we assume, what I am saying, if we assume a contour mirror and a candle, we need to consider a candle as well as contour mirror. And placing a candle and contour mirror like this, it will be. So we are considering two reflections, not one reflection, two reflections. Why? Because light will reflect number of rays. Okay, in that we are considering two rays. In that diagram, two rays are shown in the figure. See, this is ray one, this is ray two. Now, when two ray diagrams are when two rays are meeting at the contour mirror, then what will happen? They will reflect back. Okay, so this is ray diagram one and this is ray two. When they are meeting at the contour mirror in the same side, this is second side, this is first side. So when two rays are meeting in the same side, then what will happen? They will reflect back and the image will be formed at point A. But we need to find the image is clear as well as visual or real. Okay, all this we need to find by using a paper. Take the paper and keep below the point A, which means where two rays are meeting, below the point A, if we keep a mirror or if we keep a paper, in that we will find some light rays will fall at different places. Okay, two light rays will fall at different places. Now just move the paper either forward or backward. What will happen? The ray will it will become bright or dim. Basing on the, if you move forward, it will become bright. If you move backward, it will become dim. Why? Because the light which is there coming from candle is basing on that object. This light rays will reflect on the paper. Okay. Now coming to the next one. Here we take two rays. Now I am taking only ray one. Okay. So when ray one is reflected, will be line drawn from the point of incidence and it passes through the focal point. Okay, so this is the point of incidence and passes through the focal point. When it is passing through the focal point, the image will be formed as center of curvature. Okay, so what is happening in ray 1? When ray 1 light is passing, then light will passes through the focal point and the imaginary dotted lines, that dotted lines will represent the imaginary ray. That imaginary rays will be formed at center of curvature. This is the second ray. Okay. Now, if we take ray 2 here, from here I am taking. If we take ray 2, this is the ray 2, and falling on the second side of the mirror, then the ray passes through the focal point of the mirror, will travel to the principal axis, which means both are parallel, principal axis as well as the ray which is reflecting back. These two are the parallel as well as it will show, it will represent like a, it is also parallel to the principal axis. This is the ray 2. Now, for suppose that ray 3 is falling on the mirror at the downside from the center of curvature. From there, it is falling from focal point, which means focus. But here, it is falling from center of curvature. So, here center of curvature is perpendicular to the tangent of the point where lines meet. Okay, this is the total ray diagram of contour mirror. We have few more ray diagrams. I will explain you. Just listen. Diagram. Just observe the candle as well as rays. It is a bit confusing, but don't confuse. If we consider two light rays from top of the candle as well as from two light rays from bottom of the candle, then if two light rays are passing, if one of the light rays passes as well as reflected on the top surface, this is reflected one. Okay, this is first point. And the second reflected ray passes and reflects at here bottom of the mirror. And this is third reflected ray which passes and meets at here upper top of the mirror, and it will reflect downwards as well as this light ray will reflect here only. Okay, this is fourth light ray. All these light rays are meeting at focus. Okay, all these light rays are meeting at focus as well as image is formed. Okay, this is the image of the candle. This is the image of the candle which is inverted. Which is inverted? Image of the candle is forming here. It is, if we consider AB, how image is forming here at between focus as well as center of curvature is inverted. It means AB. This is B as well as this is here. Just invert the object and image is forming in between focus as well as center of curvature. This is one of the ray diagram, and this is another ray diagram. If we consider candle and the ray one is passing at the top of the mirror, which means parallel to the principal axis, and meets at the point of mirror, then it will meet at focus. Okay, it will meet at focus, and second light ray reflects down, and which is parallel to the principal axis. This is also reflects and meets at focus in between. Meets at in between focus as the center of curvature, and image will be formed at A. Okay, and now if we move object in between pole and focus, if the object is in between pole and focus, then what will happen? One of the light ray will reflect and reflects down backwards, and another light ray it will reflect like this and reflected at center of curvature. One light ray passes through the focus and second light ray passes through the center of curvature, and how image will be formed? This is the image formation of this ray diagram. This is the image formation of this ray diagram. Image will be formed at the back of the mirror. Always in plane mirrors, if we consider a plane mirror, either it is convex or concave, image will be formed at back of the mirror. Okay, that means if the light ray passes through the concave mirror, in that what will happen? The object is placed between pole as well as focus. So when the pole and in between pole and focus, the light rays will fall on the mirror and they will reflect back through this focus as well as center of curvature. So image will be formed at infinity. When we are saying image is forming at infinity, these two lines will meet at infinity position. So when we are trying to say these two lines will meet at infinity position, then what will happen? If we consider imaginary lines from these two rays, then these two rays will meet at one certain point back of the mirror. They will meet at certain point, and the image will be formed back of the mirror. Okay, that is the ray diagram for object in between pole and focus. Now, if the object is at center of curvature, then what will happen? Image will be formed at in between focus as well as center of curvature only. Okay, like this reflected light rays. This is reflected light one, ray light one, and this is reflected light ray two. So both will meet at top of the mirror as well as bottom of the mirror. They both will reflect and meet at one certain point where they are meeting. Image will be formed. Where image is forming? Focus as well as center of curvature. This image is inverted. Okay, this is erect as well as inverted image. So previously we discussed for ray diagrams on concave mirror. Now we are discussing for ray diagrams on convex mirror. We already know the difference between convex as well as concave. When the surface is inside the mirror, then that is known as the convex mirror. When the surface is outside the mirror, which means outside the spherical surface, that is known as concave mirror. Okay. Now, before discussing that convex as well as concave ray diagrams for convex mirror, we have three rules. Basing on ray diagrams, we have three rules. For each rule, we have to observe rule one: a ray parallel to the axis on the meeting convex mirror will get reflected back so as that appear and it is crossing, which means it is coming from the focal point. Just observe the diagram. When ray one is passes and it will reflect back, if you take the imaginary lines, these imaginary lines will meet at the focal point. Okay, this is the focal point, and they will meet at the focal point when light ray coming, ray one is coming from the principal axis. This is the rule one. Now coming to rule two, a ray traveling in the direction of focal point, which means if a ray is traveling in the direction of focal point, then just observe the ray diagram. Okay, when a ray is traveling in the focal point, which means in the direction of focal point, after reflection will parallel to the axis. Okay, when it is reflecting back, this is parallel to the axis, while considering this one as the axis, and both will be parallel to the principal axis. This is rule number 2. And coming to rule number 3, a ray traveling in the direction of the center of curvature, which means if the ray diagram is traveling in the direction of center of curvature and meets at center of curvature, will get reflected in the opposite direction only. So when it is coming in the form of center of curvature, then the ray will meet at this point and it will reflect back at this direction only, which means ray diagram will intersect into the lens, as well as it will reflect back from the same position. This is about rules as well as ray diagrams, which is basic on convex and contour mirrors. We learn about ray diagrams from concave mirrors as well as convex mirrors. Now we are deriving formula for curved mirrors, both convex as well as concave. Both the mirrors, we are deriving the formulas. Now if we draw the diagram, if a ray diagram which is passing from the object mode in this direction and it is getting reflected back, which means it passes and it hits the surface of the mirror and it gets reflected back and image is formed here. Center of curvature, which means a reflected light rays, okay, imaginary light rays are passing and meeting at the center of curvature, and from pole to point where the light rays hit, there the distance is PA, okay, height is h, and if we draw a straight line from A to P dash, which means if the point is meeting here near the pole, which means that point is taken as P dash. Okay, now from the diagram, if we draw the angles, okay, if we take the angles of AOC, which means angle AOC, this is the right angle triangle. From that right angle triangle, we are taking the angles of beta equal to, which means angle of beta equal to alpha plus theta, which means this is the angle of alpha as well this is the angle of theta. So beta equal to alpha plus theta, bring alpha this side, what will happen? Beta minus theta. Okay, otherwise we can do one more thing also, bring theta this side, so that is also beta minus alpha. Okay, this is angle AOC. Next one. Now from angle ACI, just check it, from angle ACI, okay, angle ACI, that is also right angle triangle. From there, if we try gamma equal to beta plus theta, okay, beta plus theta. Now theta equal to beta minus gamma, okay, beta minus gamma, this is equation 1. Now if we draw, we already know theta equal to beta minus alpha, substitute that, theta equal to beta minus alpha equal to beta minus gamma. Now add this, 2 beta equal to alpha minus gamma, okay, alpha minus gamma. So gamma equal to 2 beta minus alpha, not gamma, 2 beta minus alpha. This is the angle is forming from this, okay, just interchanging the angles. Now if we write like this, 2 beta equal to alpha plus gamma, okay, 2 beta equal to alpha plus gamma, this is equation 1. Now from equation 1 and 2, just add angles P dash O equal to, just from the angles P dash O equal to P O and P dash C equal to P C. Next P dash I equal to P I. Okay. From these only. Now if we take tan alpha equal to, if we write the angles from the right angle triangle, alpha is by base or adjacent side by base, then tan alpha equal to P A dash by P dash O, tan beta equal to P dash A by P dash C, which means hypothesis by base. Okay, next tan gamma equal to P dash A by P dash I. Okay, now I am writing from this only P dash A, which means H. P dash A means H. H by P dash A means H. Okay, so from P dash A by H by P dash O. Next here also P dash A means H by P dash C. So H by P dash I. Okay, from this only H by P dash O we can write H by P O. Okay, H by P O, H by P C, H by P I. Okay, like this it will form. Now substitute all this. If we write like this, tan beta equal to tan alpha equal to alpha equal to H by P O. Next tan beta equal to beta equal to H by P C. Next tan gamma equal to gamma equal to H by P I. Okay, all these will be formed. Now substitute alpha comma beta comma gamma values in equation 1. Okay, now substitute alpha beta gamma values in equation 1, we will get 2H by PC equal to, which means this is the value. Okay, this is the value 2 beta equal to, which means I am writing here 2 beta equal to alpha plus gamma or gamma plus alpha, anything we can write. So 2H by PC equal to H by P O plus H by P I. Here H is common, we can take common H. Okay, 2 by P C equal to 1 by P O plus 1 by P I. Okay, this is equation 2. Now just write values P O P C as well P I. Okay, P C equal to minus R, P O equal to minus 2, and P I equal to minus B. Okay, now substitute these values in that you will get those reflections like this. So 2 by minus R equal to 1 by minus 2 plus 1 by minus B. We already know that reflection R equal to 2F, which means 2 focal length. Okay, so now substitute that one. 2 by minus 2F equal to 1 by minus U plus 1 by minus B. So 2 get cancelled. 1 by F equal to 1 by minus F equal to 1 by minus U plus 1 by minus B. If we write like this, just minus is a common. So final equation will be 1 by F equal to 1 by U plus 1 by B. This is the formula for curved mirrors. So this is totally about derivation of curved mirrors, and just revise the topic on basing on cooker. Okay, solar cooker. How solar cooker is preparing? Okay, all these. How what is happened to prepare solar cooker? Just revise all the topics and once again go through from starting onwards. Now just listen the topic and just go on to the topic. If you have any doubt, just consult the teacher and I will follow up the doubts and everything. So thank you to one another.